passive house is looking at thermal bridge reconstruction. So what we really want to do is we want to analyze any of the thermal bridges that we find in the building. And what a thermal bridge is when you have either surfaces in contact with one another that have an absence of an insulation layer. So if we have, let's say, an interior drywall assembly attached to a stud, attached to an exterior sheathing, and then attached to a panel, you know, that's going to have a direct conduit for heat flow to go through that, all those different components that are in contact with one another. So we have conduction moving heat through that assembly. So we want to try to break that at some point. So, you know, for instance, on our wall assemblies, we have exterior insulation that's covering and breaking the highway for that heat transfer through those surfaces in contact with one another. So we want to go through the building and analyze where they take place and make sure that we're addressing those. And by doing that, again, we're going to reduce heat loss or heat gain, depending on the season. And we're also going to maintain high surface temperatures or comfortable surface temperatures. And by doing that, we're going to decrease the likelihood of condensation or mold growth on these surfaces. Because typically what ends up happening is as you're losing heat through those assemblies, that section of the wall is going to get cold or it's going to get warm. And we're really worried about it in the wintertime when we have, you know, actual cold stud connected to this, you know, drywall. And then if we have that temperature of that surface getting below the dew point, we can have condensation taking place on that wall. So we want to make sure from a durability standpoint that we take a look at the thermal bridges and we address every one of them in the building. So what we did as a consultant is we analyzed all of them. We identified where they took place, analyzed the impact on the building energy use and on the comfort and quality of the building. And then we put in measures that we're going to address some of the sort of the severe ones. So again, insulation outboard of the studs is one example. This is actually breaking our structural dunnage. Up on our roof, we have two rooftop HRVs that are providing ventilation to the building. But that structural steel dunnage needs to connect back down to the concrete. And in order for us to break that thermal bridge between the concrete deck and the steel dunnage, we use this Shook product. So this is actually a piece of insulation, a structural insulation product that with stainless steel bolts that we're able to now break that that linkage between the steel dunnage and the concrete. Now this is going to be completely engulfed in insulation. So as the insulation comes up, remember we have 8 inches of insulation on the roof. That's going to come up and it's going to meet this, and we're going to have one continuous insulation layer.